Hello, I'm Rob McManus, a marketing manager at Red Hat. Today, I'd like to explain how telecommunication networks are evolving and what that actually means for service providers. To optimize delivery speeds and latency for an enhanced experience, you need to distribute network functions to different parts of the network. Take the radio access network, or RAN, as an example. Traditional approaches have relied upon network functions organized in a centralized manner. Now, cloud technology actually facilitates the building of what we call a distributed RAN and will offer benefits such as increased flexibility and lower costs. Consider one of the RAN functions, the distributed unit or the DU. A cloud-native approach will allow for the DU to be placed at the edge of the network. Now, given the size and the density of a typical service provider RAN, this actually equates to tens of thousands of RAN DU functions in any given network. So how do service providers deploy and operate their RAN networks at this level of scale? Well, the answer is by using automation. Let me show you how we achieve this at Red Hat. A cloud-native platform with automated or zero-touch provisioning capabilities is key in managing a service provider's RAN at scale. Red Hat OpenShift has the capabilities you need to deliver a flexible, high-performing, efficient, and agile RAN. OpenShift operators and validated RAN profiles configure and optimize the platform to ensure the necessary performance for deterministic RAN workloads. Automation and zero-touch provisioning can be achieved using a declarative specification and also something called a GitOps framework. A declarative approach defines a desired state. Now, using the RAN DU as the example, the required resources and configuration for a RAN DU site are stored in something called a Git repository. A declarative approach eliminates the manual steps required to individually configure RAN DU sites. In conjunction with a GitOps framework, service providers can provision the RAN DU sites in a fraction of the time that would be normally taken, which massively increases their efficiency. So let me show you GitOps in action. The desired RAN DU state is pulled automatically from a Git repository. Red Hat OpenShift GitOps observes the RAN DU state and applies continuous remediation by correcting any configuration drift. If Red Hat OpenShift GitOps needs to redeploy to a stable version of the desired state, it can do this faster than a service provider having to execute this process manually. Red Hat Advanced Cluster Management is also used for the automation and zero-touch provisioning of RAN DU sites and provides policy-based governance and application lifecycle management. Let me show you more details and the role of policies. The desired RAN DU state is defined as a collection of policies. Common policies are applied to each and every RAN DU site. They include a performance add-on, single root I/O virtualization or SRIOV, which is used for increased packet throughput, something called Precision Time Protocol or PTP for timing, logging capabilities and local storage. Group policies are used for specific groups of RAN DU sites, and they are used to disable unnecessary features to increase performance. Cluster policies are used for specific RAN DU clusters, configuring various cluster and performance optimizations. These include network acceleration, RAN forward error correction or FEC, and precision time protocol or PTP. Red Hat's single node OpenShift is used as the platform for the RAN DU. Single node OpenShift is a full OpenShift deployment, and it has both management and worker node capabilities within a single server. Due to its small footprint, single node OpenShift has the ability to act independently and autonomously and has no dependency whatsoever on a centralized management cluster. let me show you the complete RANDU site deployment using both automation and zero-touch provisioning. Deployment of the RANDU is executed and monitored using Red Hat Advanced Cluster Management. The deployment process includes installing the host operating system on a blank server, deploying Red Hat single node OpenShift, applying cluster policies, establishing the necessary network configurations to the operating system, deploying pre-validated RAN profile operators, performance profiles, and other RAN-specific configurations, and downloading the images needed to run the RANDU workloads. Once complete, service providers have a fully operational RANDU site. Here at Red Hat, we have the solutions to help service providers deploy and operate their RAN at scale. We simplify site configuration, we reduce manual intervention, and we make it easier to manage thousands of distributed sites and network functions across an entire service provider's network. To learn more, contact us today.